Now hunting. Okay. So this is one more important point. Once the synchronous motor rotor is locked with the opposite pole of the rotating magnetic field, it will rotate in the same direction, continuously in the same direction of the rotating magnetic field with the same speed of the rotating magnetic field. For example, 4 pole 50 hertz system. So the rotating magnetic field speed is 1500 rpm, it will run. Now rotor is locked, magnetically locked with the rotating magnetic field. Now assume the motor is running in no load condition. So what is the delta in no load condition? In no load condition, the rotor is exactly synchronized or locked, magnetic locking, exactly magnetically locked with the rotating magnetic field. So the delta value is zero no load. Okay, this is normal operation. Now I am suddenly increasing the load from zero load, 0% of the load, to some 100% of the load. Suddenly applying the load on the motor. So what will happen? Immediately delta will increase. You know the relationship between delta and load. So higher load, higher delta. So suddenly you are increasing at fraction of a second. You are applying the 100% load. What will happen? Immediately the rotor retard with some angle. That means the rotor slows down. So that means the rotor try to come out from the synchronism or rotating magnetic field, magnetic locking, try to come out from the magnetic locking. At that case, what will happen? So there is a damper winding. You know the relationship. Whenever conductor cuts the magnetic flux, EMF will induce. Now rotating magnetic field is one direction that will run at constant speed, 1500 rpm. Now because of increment in the load, the rotor speed slightly decreases, say 1495 rpm, for example I am saying. Okay, so there is a small speed difference, so between the rotating magnetic field and rotor. Now what will happen? Because of this speed difference, EMF will induce in the rotor, that is a damper winding. So damper winding is nothing but squirrel cage winding. So this is one winding. Okay, so in that winding, damper winding, that is called damper winding, normally it is placed in the pole face. This is the pole. Okay, so pole face of the rotor. So in that damper winding, the EMF will induce, that will produce the current. Okay, that will produce the current. In any circuit, there is a closed path and voltage, so automatically current will flow. So because of this speed difference, 1500 and 1495, there is 5 rpm difference. For this 5 rpm, EMF will induce in the damper winding. So that will drive the current. Already the damper winding is short circuited, closed path. So that will produce the current. Any current carrying conductor produces its own flux. So that will produce one flux. Okay. That will produce one flux. That means now the rotor flux is increased because of this. Okay, so rotor flux increased. That means the rotor once again goes to synchronism, pulled into synchronism. Okay, so now the delta value less compared to previous case. Okay, so now you can see this one up to this. So this is without damper winding. If you have damper winding, the oscillation is immediately removed. Okay. So this is called delta, load angle. So once the rotor runs, starts to run at same speed of the rotating magnetic field, what will happen? Same speed of the rotating magnetic field, there is no current in the damper winding. So when the damper winding will carry the current, if the rotor try to comes out from the synchronism, when the rotor will try to comes out from the synchronism, if you increase the load suddenly, okay.